Thank you. Thank you. know you're in the middle of this event going on, so I appreciate you taking out time to be on the air with us this morning.
Thank you for having us.
Yes, thank you very much. There are 25 HOAs, and each HOA has to get to Sunny Hannah to get out of here.
Right. If there was an emergency, God forbid, there is absolutely no way the people in this community could safely exit. There's no way. It would be physically impossible. So when you're looking at safety of a community, this builder has not even considered that at all.
Yes, but you voted against
that's
it.
That's pretty cool.
When it
Don
came
and I started to see
it. You voted against it.
Our whole thought was, would it be cool if we had any danger?
Yeah, there's no.
There are other options to happen here. There are definitely other options. And unfortunately, huh? Can you?
Yeah.
Can you smile? But, I mean, we didn't know about a limpkin last year or the year before.
Yeah.
We just found this.
I never heard of a limpkin.
We just
this morning on the radio.
What is, we don't understand the council. What the heck is going on? Why do they keep voting?
Well, let me, I got a meeting with some people with that. Let's see what we can do. No promises at all.
Mm-hmm.
We need somebody on council to stand up and say all this is wrong. All this development is wrong. People are accusing
this not all development is wrong. You can't stop development. Stop development does the thing if you don't want it.
Gary, can I just make a statement?
Sure.
We have 1,200 homes here already. Our 1,200 doors homes. There is a maximum limit of how many doors you're supposed to have in the before you have to have a second ingress egress. That was brought up already with the planning commission. Now you can add another 500 homes, and we have only one way.
I understand
way,
that, but they're going
one
by
way.
08 rules.
They're going by what?
2008 rules and 1984 rules.
It's 2021.
I think, from what I understand, he owns both sides right here, both sides of this entranceway, going into the neighborhood, and the entire roadway as well.
Yeah.
The entire roadway is private.
Thank you.
got some ideas. I'm not going to elaborate on it anymore now because I don't want to give any false hope in any way, shape, or form about where we might go from here. The Planning Commission is done with it. There's no more to be said. What I don't understand is, I know y'all have been there, so I understand why you're there, but why are people even thinking about buying there if things are going to, you know, end up being like we know that they're going to be? I just don't understand. Why would you buy a house when you go down a pothole road to get to? But I guess the beach and the weather and all that good stuff is just a siren singing their song, and they just keep coming. But I've got some ideas, and I don't know what might transpire of them, but certainly I was there for, what, an hour or more, and saw those trucks going up and down Simi Hanna, and that in and of itself is kind of crazy. And obviously they aren't going to fix the road until the trucks are done. I mean, it wouldn't make any sense to fix it. And I understand he said he's going to fix it. Is that true? Did he say it?
He said that after a certain phase of building, then the road would be fixed.
Is he going to turn it over to you?
You go.